Glitchy and welcome. Welcome to a new episode of Inno Update. My name is Maarten Kos and Inno Update is all about corporate innovation. And today's topic is 10 habits of killing innovation. Let's start off with number 10. Yes, so that's the current business model dominates the agenda of leadership. So what can you do about it? Well, change your organization to an ambidexterity, in an ambidextrous organization. I've posted two other videos on this topic called ambidexterity and dual innovation. So check it out if you want to know more about that. So number 9 is all about insisting on untested and detailed business plans. Middle management wants business plans for your innovation. That doesn't work. So stick to the business plans for your core of your business. And for innovation, use different kind of methodology. For example, the lean startup methodology. Number 8. When do you progress with your innovation? In some of the organizations, it's the hypo whose opinion matters the most, the highest paid person in the room. And if he or she is saying, okay, we should progress with this innovation, it works. Don't do that. Don't use the hypo, but use innovation metrics. Use evidence to process and to see if an innovation works or doesn't work. If you do it like this, it can save you a lot of money and time in innovation. So number 7, it's about outsourcing your customer discovery and testing. So a lot of companies are outsourcing these innovation activities. Don't do that. Try to do it yourself. Try to get out of the building. Do this testing yourself. You can, of course, hire consultants to help you with the process and with the methodology, but make sure your corporate startup teams and also your management knows about innovation and actually is doing it, because that's the way you are creating this ambidextrous organization. Number six is about senior leadership. Most of the time, senior leaderships are too busy for the hands-on innovation. Of course, they say, okay, I'll give you time, I'll give you room, here you have an innovation lab. But you have to make sure that the senior leaders are also getting out of the building, doing innovation projects, that the leaders really understand, not only from reading a book, but actually doing the innovation. So another bad habit is number 5. It's about people are more obsessed with the competitors than with your customers. And rule number 1 of innovation is be obsessed over your customers, over the problems your customers are facing, because you need to solve these problems and then you can create new business models. Number four is all about technology risk. Most of the companies, especially companies which are very technology driven, are focusing more on the risk of technology than on other risks. And there are a lot of risks which you should be aware of. So if you take a look at the other risk, the first risk should be, is this a viable product? Can we make business of it? Can we scale it? Then, of course, is it desirable? Do people want it? Does the consumer want this kind of product? Is it feasible? Can we make this product or this solution within our organization? And the last one, is it adaptable enough? Can it adapt to new legislation, to new competitors? So these risks are much more important than most of the technology risks. Okay, number 3, innovation is career limiting. In some of the companies I've met, if you do innovation, you won't get far on the career ladder. Please award innovation. Please help people who are doing innovation. It is something which is truly part of your company. So don't put it in a corner, don't put it in a lab. Try to stimulate innovation in all parts of your company. Number 2. All about the silos in your organization. Try to break down these silos. Try to create a culture where executors and innovators can collaborate. This is also part of the dual innovation within your organization, but this is truly something which helps you succeed innovation within your company. And the last, number 1 bad habit about integrating new ideas into the execution engine too quickly. So that's happened a lot. So if you have your innovation hub and your corporate startup teams, they're doing a great job. And then the core is saying, okay, let's do it. Let's try to make it into the core of our organization. Don't do that. Protect the new ideas until they are fully mature. And this is all about the second playing field. If you want to know more about that, that's the playing field between the innovation teams who do the experimental innovation and the core of the organization. This playing field too is very important. If you want to know more, check out my episode on dual innovation. I think Alexander Osterwalder, who put these 10 bad habits together, made a fair point. But I think you can also within your organization see other types of risks, some other types of bad habits which are happening within your company. For an innovator, it's hard. It's hard to work in a company, but be aware that there are a lot of other corporate innovators out there who are facing the same challenges. So let's reach out and try to learn from each other. If you want to learn more, check out the show notes where I will put a link to Alexander Osterwalder's original blog post and also to some other links like the Ambidexterous organization, dual innovation. In that way, you can dive deeper into this topic. If you have any questions or other topics I should address, reach out to me via LinkedIn or send me an email. And I hope to see you back next week with a new episode of InnoUpdate. And in the meantime, keep innovating.